Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Secretary, in August, your department recommended the reclassification of marijuana from to a Schedule 3 for the Drug Enforcement Administration. Previous administrations had used a five-factor test to determine what the scheduling of a drug should be, but this administration, your office, has created a new two-factor test to determine currently accepted medical use. What's the reason for the change?
Senator, thank you for the question. And as you'll see from the report that has now been made public, there has been a lot of science that's been collected over the years on cannabis. We have far more information now. As you know, throughout the country, many states have moved much farther than the federal government has. Even in places like Texas, you see where action has been taken on cannabis. What we're doing is simply reflecting what the science is showing.
You compared it to heroin in terms of its potential for abuse. Why didn't you compare other types of drugs that are scheduled by the by your office?
I'm going to try not to speak directly for the FDA because the FDA did this assessment analysis independently from HHS. They are the agency that has been tasked with that job with their scientists, and I won't try to speak for them, but what I will tell you is that the rigorous work that was done to come to these conclusions was based on the science and the evidence they had before them.
Did they do additional research into adolescent brain development or mental health consequences or impact on pregnant women?
I'm sure they took into consideration all the information out there on both the effects and the evidence that there is on cannabis use.
You're saying that for a fact?
Senators, I'm saying I don't want to try to speak for the FDA and its scientists because I didn't do the actual assessment, but I'm pretty,
you announced a recommendation. I assume you would take into account impact on adolescent brain development, on mental health consequences, or pregnant women?
As I said, I'm sure that the FDA would have taken into account all of the different circumstances involved. I didn't make the recommendation. It was made by FDA.
I want to follow up on some of the questions that Senator Menendez and Senator Grassley asked. Your department is responsible for the administration of the Office of Refugee Resettlement, correct?
That's correct.
And that means that any unaccompanied children who come to our border are basically transferred to your care by the Border Patrol, correct?
That's correct.
And you identify a sponsor for them in the interior of the United States, correct?
That's our obligation, yes.
Yes. And there have been about 400,000 of these unaccompanied children that have come to the United States during President Biden's term of office. Can you tell us where they are now?
We can give you information on the vetting process and
No, I ask you, do you know where they are now?
As I said to you, we can tell you who the vetted sponsors were that received
That's
these
That's not
kids.
What I ask you. I know that you've interviewed sponsors to some extent, although not adequately. I agree with Senator Menendez. But do you have any responsibility for their welfare as you sit here today?
While they are in our custody, we have jurisdiction to provide them with
I'm
the care that they
I'm talking about
need.
Now that they're in custody of your vetted sponsors.
Senator, you and your colleagues did not give us jurisdiction to provide the oversight of these children once they left our care.
So that's not your responsibility, is it what you're saying?
We don't have jurisdiction. We can't spend money on things we don't have jurisdiction.
So you don't know whether they're being trafficked for sex, whether they're being forced into dangerous jobs of child labor. You don't know whether they're going to school. You don't know whether they're getting the health care they need. You simply don't know, correct?
Well, while they are in our care, we know all of those things and they don't have
Well, they are no longer in your care once you transfer them to the sponsors, right?
As I said, Senator, the statutes that you all passed don't give us the authority to monitor these kids once
so
they are out of our custody.
So whose responsibility is it to look after the welfare of these children?
My understanding is the statutes that you all passed left that open for the communities where they enter.
Say that again?
My understanding is the statutes that you all enacted that said that our jurisdiction over these kids ends once we have delivered them to a vetted sponsor is that the communities where they reside will now be in charge of providing for their services.
So as a result of the broken border policies of the Biden administration, these kids have been placed with sponsors. You don't know where they are. You don't know what's happening to them. You don't think that's your responsibility, and you frankly don't care.
No, that's not accurate. And these laws preceded President Biden taking office. This system has been broken, as you know and I know, for more than 40 years, or close to 40 years. You and I have been in Congress for quite some time. I started in Congress back in 93.
Well, you have a job to do right now. You have about a $1.8 trillion budget, and you have the responsibility for taking care of these children, and you simply hand them off to sponsors, to homes that you don't know the conditions they're living in. You don't
That's
know
not
that
true.
They're going to school, whether That's they're being sold for sex or trafficked or forced into labor. You don't know, and you don't think it's your responsibility, correct?
No, I would dispute pretty much what you just said, Senator.
The time of the gentleman's expired.